Hello everyone, today I am going to discuss on how you can perform a link audit or a backlink audit for your campaign and why it is needed and what are some of the areas by which you can make it happen. So let us first understand what is link audit. So basically every website can have an n number of backlinks or can have an enormous amount of backlinks. Now you need to make sure that these backlinks do not come from irrelevant sources. The backlinks are not spam in nature. The backlinks are not causing any toxicity in your campaign. If you do so, then Google might lead you into a penalty zone and your campaign can get a decline in organic traffic and also in organic ranking. So it is advisable for every SEO experts that they should conduct a thorough link audit for their campaigns using the available tools as shown in the screen. So you can use all these tools as you can see from the screen for your link audit purposes, and with the help of link audit you can minimize your spam score, you can minimize the chances of toxic level, and also you can minimize the chances of getting a penalty into the Google. When conducting a link audit, you need to keep in mind of a numerous amount of checklists. Some of them as you can show from the screen, starting from link velocity all the way up to the bottom. These are the checklists which you need to ensure while conducting a link audit from the tools that I have just shown. One of the main factors which can help you in conducting a good link audit is understanding what your spam score is. Now if you ask me what is a spam score, so spam score basically is a percentage out of 100 which shows how much spam your link is compared to your overall collection of your backlinks. For instance, if suppose you have 10% spam score, which means that 10% of your overall backlinks are spammed. Now Google's recommended guidelines obviously is to keep as low as possible, but industrial experts believe that if it is within like 7%, it is good to go. But it is my recommendation that keep it as low as possible. For instance, our campaign contains 2% spam score and this is good. So now the thing is, for understanding why spam score can lead you into a penalty, so you first need to understand what is the purpose of search engines. Now search engines like Google, Bing, DuckDuckGo and etc, their main purpose is to show relevant and useful links or resources in front of their users. Now if a particular campaign can have a bad spam score, that means that much of the backlinks or the authority which they have gained are from spammed websites and they are leading into a negative user experience. And if Google finds or if search engine finds that there is a negative user experience going on, then they are bound to give you a penalty that can lead to drop in ranking, drop in traffic, drop in search visibility, and your SEO entire structure would be totally destroyed in seconds. So spam score should be limited and spam score should be reduced as much as practical. Now there is just one solution to prevent that, that is using a proper disavow from time to time. Now disavow is a feature that can be found on every Google search console where you can make a list of all of the spam backlinks. Now just to add a few points, spam backlinks can be identified by three sources. First thing, you need to make sure on what low profile the backlinks are coming, like if some backlinks are coming from less than 10 DA authority websites or if some backlinks are coming from zero organic traffic websites. Point number two, the backlink site should be relevant to the niche. Point number three, the backlink site should not be spammy itself, like it should not be like from any guest commenting platform where there is n number of different other commenting. So once you identify all the backlinks, you can make a list of all the backlinks in a disavow.txt file and then you can upload the file on the disavow section of the search console as you can see from the screen, and from there you can click the disavow and your entire link collection of the spam backlinks can get disavowed by the Google. So it is my advisable recommendation that you can perform this every 21 days because this can help you to keep your link profile healthy and this would make sure that you are not getting any penalty in the Google. So three takeaways from this episode. First one is always perform a link audit. Make sure there is no spam score. Even if there is a spam score, try to make it as low as possible, below 5% if possible. Point number two, use disavow function because this is what can help you to make sure your spam is controlled and you can get rid of all of the negative backlinks which you have earned. Point number three, always build well, good and relevant backlinks to your niche. This can help you in prevention of spam backlinks in the near future. Thanks once again for watching this episode.